ton of response on Twitter to this, of a routine traffic stop that turned into a violent brawl after a mom in a minivan full of her 5 children got pulled over for speeding.
You're doing 71 back there in a 55, okay? You're gonna receive a citation.
Suddenly, the woman drove away. The police chased her, and when she stopped, this happened.
Get out of the vehicle. Get out of the vehicle right now.
You can hear screaming from inside the van as the officer tries to pull the woman out. After some arguing, she does get out. The officer tells her to turn around and face the vehicle, but she walks away from him. In the commotion, the woman's 14-year-old son gets out, and for reasons that are under investigation now, the officer pulls out a taser, so the boy rushes back into the van.
Open the door!
Open the door!
There is more screaming, and then the officer starts smashing the rear window with a club. The mom then screeches away. Another officer arrives on the scene and fires at least 3 shots at the van. The woman then surrendered eventually at a hotel. Can you even believe this? I mean, this is unbelievable. Anna Yum joins us now, former prosecutor, and Jeff Gold is a criminal defense attorney. This was her kids age 6 to 18, 5 children. They were on their way to the Rio Grande for a family outing when all of this started to ensue. I mean, Anna, obviously, she should have, you know, sort of gone along with the police and, you know, pulled over. I mean, that's simply what you do. But the police shooting at a minivan with 5 children in it?
Yeah, absolutely right, Martha. Nice to see you. Cooler heads did not prevail in this case for all parties involved. The mother clearly was in the wrong for not pulling over and not complying. But at the end of the day, the officer's actions in shooting 3 live rounds at a moving target, in this case, a minivan full of children, I mean, that could really land him in some hot water here. The main question is, were the officer's actions reasonable? Was it justified to use deadly force?
Yeah.
And officers are held to a higher standard based upon their training and experience to be able to contain a situation. Now, based upon what we see in this video, it looks like she wasn't posing a deadly threat to the officer. She wasn't pulling out a gun. She wasn't using knives. She wasn't trying to run the officer over.
This
and of course, I'm not defending her actions here, but I think that there were other measures the officer could have used.
You know, not to mention, shooting at the van is one thing, right? But smashing the windows so glass is flying everywhere with 5 kids inside this van. I mean, clearly, you know, I think what happened, Jeff, is that when they said to her, turn around and face your car, she became really nervous because she thought they were going to handcuff her and take her away from her children.
Right.
Well, she's apparently had some DWIs, so maybe she was worried about that.
No convictions, according to her attorney. I mean, I don't know if he's right about that, but he claims that there are no convictions. And I also want to be clear about one other thing here, because they claim that they found 2 marijuana pipes in the car. That's the claim. No drugs in the car at all, because a lot of people are writing to us and saying, oh, you know, it was, you know, she deserved to be taken away because of these other issues. But I just don't know at this point. Go ahead, Jeff.
Martha, look what these officers were facing. First of all, she leaves the first stop, she eludes. And when she eludes, she takes it into the realm of a criminal offense now. It's not just leaving, you know, the scene of something. She's actually fleeing the police. They're not finished. They have to stop her a second time. They get her out. She's uncooperative. She's struggling. Her son gets out of the car, basically attacks the officer. It's lucky for him he didn't get tasered. And then after all that, they leave again. Now, I agree that the next officer that comes, the assisting officer, is probably out of bounds. But the issue, constitutionally, is number one, you can stop a fleeing felon with deadly force if, as Anna said, it's reasonable. He's now saying he just was trying to shoot out the tires, but frankly, even shooting out the tires is very unreasonable when you got 6 kids in the car.
Agreed. But Anna, what about this question? Did she put her children in jeopardy when she refused to cooperate?
You can definitely say that, Martha. You can definitely say that she's the one responsible for putting her kids in that type of situation, in that dangerous type of situation. But at the end of the day, the officer could have used his gun, threatened her and said, get out, and ordered her out at gunpoint. There was no need for the officer, the original officer, to start bashing the windows. And what good did that do? If anything, it scared her even more. And of course, for the assisting officer to come and unload his firearm on this car of children, I mean, that in my opinion, there's no justification for that. That's completely unreasonable, yeah. And there's no reason that he should have used deadly force.
All right, boy, that's some of the craziest scenes I have seen in quite some time. And as you say, cooler heads did not prevail on any side in that whole arrangement. Thank you so much. Thanks, Jeff. Thanks, Anna.
Thanks,
boy,
Bubba.
There's something to talk about today, huh?
You could roll the window down, or you can take it out with a billy club.
Slam it out with a billy club.